What is taking so long?
I know, we've been waiting for a poo for an hour.
Could it be the sign?
Yeah.
Good idea, the fish are sticklers for manners.
And there we have it, a fish poo.
Use the world's smallest pooper scooper and get it out.
This fish poo will be the first non-mammal specimen for Dr. Zahn's incredible, inedible poo-poo emporium. I have literally lots of different kinds of poo.
Can I have a tour?
Not
until we've had a gross alert.
Gross alert!
Gross alert. Not for the squeamish.
See if you can guess what animal that is from and what animal that is from.
Ugh.
We both have gloves on and we're trained doctors, so we can examine these samples. But you're not a trained doctor, as far as we know, so never touch or play with poo.
I think this is an animal that eats meat. It's grey. It looks like a very big version of my cat's poo. This one is full of fur, so I'm also going to guess that this is from another, even bigger cat. So I'm going to say that one's from a leopard and that one's from a lion.
Well, look, you did very well. The first one is from a cheetah, and the second one was, in fact, from a tiger. Okay, the next poo is a very exciting one.
It smells really fruity, actually. So this is a very big animal that eats fruit and nuts and little berries.
A bear?
It is. It's a Syrian bear's poo.
Mr. Grumble's got the poos off his mates at the zoo.
Chris, one final poo for you to guess. Have a look at this.
Oh, dear. Very, very smelly, slimy. And this is an animal that's been eating sweet corn.
Ha-ha! Well, can you guess what animal it came from? Is it A, a rhino, B, a gorilla, or C, me, Dr. Zahn'd? Well, I'm proud to say the answer is C! It's my poo! Ugh.
None of these poos look much like the food that they came from. So how does your gut turn your food into your poo?
We're going to take a close look at the digestive system. Mega gross alert!
Chris, this is the complete digestive system of a pig.
It might look a bit gross, but this is everything that's involved in processing food, from the tongue all the way to the bum. We've laid it out so that you can see every organ, and it's a lot like yours.
It's amazing, Zahn'd.
Now, we're gonna start at the top with the tongue, and its job is to mash the food up and then push it down the esophagus, which leads to the stomach, mixed with some of the digestive juices. And the food starts to go into the first bit of the small intestine. And now, for the first time ever, we're going to hear and see a tummy rumble. Boom in!
Have a listen.
Well, that's amazing, isn't it?
That noise is air and water being pushed through the gut, past the remains of your food. But is your food poo yet? Well, let's have a look. Zahn'd, seems a bit runny to me.
Oh! That liquid, that's called chyme. And chyme is halfway on the journey between food and poo.
What's interesting is it doesn't actually smell bad at all.
So now we're cutting into the large intestine.
It's here that chyme becomes poo.
That looks and smells a lot more like poo. The reason it smells is because there are lots of bacteria in the colon helping digestion,